qu'on aimerait faire au Ghana, non?
C'est sûr.
Comme tu dis. Dear viewers, le Ghana. So we have moved with our 16th video. Our project, our language project, don't forget, is quite interesting and fruitful. We are moving on very well with the 16th video. We are going to talk about the future tense. We want to ask fathers. In our last video, the 15th video, we had a summary of some important verbs. And we're going to move to the 16th video on the future tense. So for the details about the future tense.
Future tense, yes, is expressing what is still to come.
Okay.
Yeah. Any expression of something still to come. It could be in the next 1 hour, it could be in the evening, it could be tomorrow, it could be next year. All is that it has not yet happened, it's still to come. Okay. Still to happen. Yeah. That is the future.
So how is that expressed in Bangla? In when?
In when the future is simple, you just make the personal pronoun and the verb.
Okay.
Yeah. The intonation plays a major part in the conjugation.
Wow, interesting.
Yeah. It has no help of any article.
I see.
Like in the other tenses.
Tenses.
You remember in the present tense,
yeah,
there was some words in between.
In between.
For example,
yes,
I am eating me si du bon. So me si is the article, the word in between, as a help, an auxiliary to conjugating in the present or present continuous. Okay. But the future, it's not present.
The pronoun and the verb.
Mm-hmm. For example,
let's
take to go.
Okay.
I will go, you will go, he will go, we will go, you will go, and they will go. We'll put it in the future, allegor. Okay. To go, allegor.
Yes.
Mungwa. I will go. Mungwa.
Okay.
You will go. Gogua.
Okay.
Gogua.
Yes.
He or she will go. Jigua.
Okay.
Jigua. We will go. Bugua.
Okay.
Bugua. You will go. Bugua.
Okay.
Bugua. They will go. Bo-gua.
So there's no change. It's always
there is a change. There is a change only the persons.
Exactly.
The pronouns. Yes.
So in terms of the verb is
almost
set.
The same in the future.
Mm-hmm. That's quite interesting.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you will go.
Bo-gua.
They will go,
bo-gua. Okay.
So it's the same in terms of the verb, but the pronoun changes.
Exactly. To differentiate the person.
To differentiate the person, yeah, but the verb itself, the pronoun remains almost the same.
That's quite interesting.
Yeah.
It's quite simple.
And it's simple. The future tense is quite simple.
Quite simple.
But the intonation is
the problem.
Which you have to master.
Wow, interesting. So let's take another very easy.
Because problem. if you were to just not make the intonation, but you maintain as a present tense.
That's true.
Yes, maintain as a present tense. For example, this allegor in the present, we said me singua. I am going. Yeah. And we say that. Most often, it is the present tense is expressed in mwe as present continuous. Most simple. While the future just mean mungwa. But there's another expression of a future. It has two ways.
Oh, interesting.
Mm-hmm.
We really like to know the other way from.
The next form of future is something that will take place in the far future. This one is the one that will take place in the near future. In the far future, Mwen expresses the far future as it has now an auxiliary in between the subject and the verb.
Interesting.
And that word is nde. Nde.
Nde.
Nde.
Okay.
So take again the example of
Tuku
Alegua.
Yes.
Mende gua.
Okay.
Mende gua. I will go back in the far. The future, which is the,
which is
still far.
Let's say 1 year.
In 1 year or next month or whatever.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Mende gua.
Mende gua.
Yes. Then.
You will go.
Okay.
The N changes into the L.
So we have mu.
Mu nde for
the I. N,
yeah, for I.
Then you will be.
You go le gua.
Okay. Ne.
Only the L changes into the L.
Okay.
He or she will go. Je le gua.
Okay.
Je le gua.
Yes.
We will go. Bu le gua.
Okay.
Bu le gua.
Okay. You will.
You will go. Bu le gua.
Okay.
Bu le gua.
And they will go.
They will go. Bu le gua.
Bu le.
Bu le gua.
So everything is le le le. Except
the first takes the rest is L. Mm-hmm. So that is the future which is near,
yes,
and the future
which is far,
yes, having this auxiliary as de or le
to express
that it is still very far.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. It's not just so near.
Wow. Thank you very
so
much.
That is that for the future. Two forms. Mm-hmm. The future, near future, and the far future.
Thank you very much, Father, for this important lesson on future tense.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Is there any other thing to add on the future tense?
We can only just take another example.
Okay, Father, that would be wonderful.
Yeah. So, to come. Let's take the verb to come.
Mm-hmm.
Which is
for
Aleph.
Okay.
Aleph.
In a short form.
In the near future.
Okay.
Near future, we say, Mofo. I will come. Mofo.
Okay.
You will come. Gofo.
Okay.
He or she will come. Jifo. We will come before.
Okay.
You will come before.
Okay.
They will come before.
Interesting. This is the short form of the
that
future.
Is the near, near future.
Thank you for that.
Near future.
Near future. Near future.
Yes. And the far future of to come.
Mm-hmm.
I will come. Mundefu. Mundefu.
Okay.
You will come. Golefu. He or she will come. Jilefu.
Okay.
We will come. Bulefu.
Okay.
You will come. Bulefu.
Okay.
They will come. Boulef.
Very, very simple and understood. As long as
these auxiliaries are used.
Interesting.
Yes.
Comité de monde.
So that is it for the future. They remember near future, far future.
Comité de monde.
Abonté.
Comité.
Interrogation.
So dear viewers, we've learned the future tense, the conjugation, the near form and the far form.
Far form, yeah.
So the difference is the auxiliary which you put
before the verb
to express that it's far. Okay. We have there, we have le, which is continuous. And thank you very much for watching. Catch you in the next video.
Ciao.
Whoa.